Welcome back to another new edition of Women of Windows on Current Affairs. And today we celebrate a very important day. Actually, it's a day that is supposed to be celebrated on March 8th each year. The whole world celebrates it, celebrating International Women's Day. A day where all women would come together under the belief of equality, gender equality, and equality on all spheres of life, and also would come together and unite under the belief that equality is not a social development, but a basic human right that, of course, cannot be ignored. It's a day where women defy societal discriminating views of them and remind them of their rights and remind them of all the achievements that they have come a long way since the early 50s or even 60s. Above all, it's a day to celebrate women's freedoms and courage. And at the same time, it's an alarming bell that reminds us of how far we have come and how long we still have to go. It's a very important day to every Egyptian woman and all women around the world. And we're very delighted to have with us celebrating that day with their own input and their own views, Dr. Hoda Rizana, former Member of Parliament, Dr. Iman Peppers, founder of an NGO for empowering women's rights in Egypt. Good evening, ladies, and happy International Women's Day.
Well, good evening, and we are very happy to be with you at this special day.
Let me start by you, Dr. Peppers. For Egyptian women, today is not like yesterday. I mean, the assessment of the Egyptian women's status, it's not like yesterday. So how far is that true to you? How do you assess that idea?
There are various ways to do this, because women are not a homogeneous group. There are different types of women. Mm. But I mean, if you think about what we have now, we have 70 women in the parliament, which is, you know, around 15% of the parliament, much more than when we had it in 2005 and 2010, when they were only between 2 and 2.2%. Mm. So whatever we say, there is, on that level, a very good progress. On the other hand, we have also extremely very well-educated, highly educated, three very powerful women in the ministry. So we have Dr. Ghadawani, we have Dr. Sahar Nas, and we have Dr. Makram Abid, the Minister of Immigration. So on that level, there is a direction towards really empowering women, or at least finding a space for women on the political sphere, on that level. Mm. However, saying that, I think there has been also a recession or a regression since the Arab Spring, or since the revolution of 2011, where there has been a lot of voices going against women's liberation. There has been a lot of fundamentalists asking women to stay home. There has been a lot of attempts to try to change the personal status law, not to benefit women more, on the contrary, but to make her lose some of the gains that she had achieved before. Mm. So, I mean, if we're saying the good things and the bad things, that's where we are. I just also want to add something, that although there is still sexual harassment in the streets, it has been reduced a lot. Mm. So, I mean, I just want to say, I want to be balanced and I want to be fair. Mm. There are things that are not bad. We wanted more, and we can talk about this later. There is much more, you know, women were the reason behind the 30s of the revolution. Women were very, very clearly participating with a lot of energy in the referendum of the constitution, in the election of the president. Women played a very important role in the Egypt we have now. So I think we expected more as women at every level. But at the same time, there are things that are not so bad.
Right. Dr. Rizana, although Egypt has signed many international agreements pledging to protect and guarantee women's equality under the law, of course including the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, and that was in 1984, yet many areas still remain vague and they need explanation. I mean, how do you see that, and where are those areas in particular?
Well, as a matter of fact, we are struggling and fighting the effect of the invasion of the radical groups into our society. Mm. And this is a very serious point. We have to face it clear and crystal clear. Why? Mm. We have to admit that lowering the level of knowledge and the cultural level of the Egyptian woman was affected badly since the last 10 years. Mm. I was in the parliament 2000. Though our number was not that 80 or 70 or whatever.
We can take a comprehensive assessment of
yes,
the former
yes,
member of
because
parliament.
This is, we were a very arrogant and brains in the parliament. was each one has his own, her own entity, and beside that they are knowledgeable and they are, were enjoying the growth in a healthy society. The society now is not very healthy for the women and for the young girls. If you can see young girls stopped and prevented to go certain areas and they are not doing their natural life, how you can judge the brain of this woman? How this will be a well-balanced grown lady which she has no identity and she doesn't belong. She's not Egyptian, the way they look. The way they look like a Pakistani or whatever the earth, and the, even the Wahhabi. And this is the area we have to, I mean, if you have an abscess, you have to make an incision and evacuate and clean and make it healing properly.
You have to give radical solutions.
Yes, yes, and heal this abscess in a prompt way, not in a very, you know, 50%. Which we are not going to touch this because we are going to, we have to be very sharp, sharp edge, and we have to tell the girls know their rights since their childhood. Because having any oppression on a young girl in the school, giving her instruction that she's forbidden to do so and so, or she has to have a certain appearance, this will depress her psychological life and emotional, and even the way she think, the intelligence, even Q, IQ, it will be affected. So
No sports
in the school there. So we are now reviving. We are starting to put our, you know,
do you think that we have set our feet on exporting the right culture right now?
I think we are fighting at this direction. We are fighting because we have to admit the effect which was done with these groups. When I say these groups, I mean, and you understand what I mean.
The Salafis and the Muslim Brothers.
Yes. And the issue is that they are putting pressure on and terrorizing the young females, even in their neighbors and their rivals and in their countries and in their villages. So they put a stress on them. Wear that, don't put a niqab, all these covering in sense of oppression. This is an oppression on any young girl, any young woman, which you have to deal with and make it very clear that we have a healthy society. We have to have a healthy life for the young girls and for the growing girls and for the future mothers. You have to bring a good generation coming from this woman and cultured, not deployed from her original culture. She don't know her history, at least Egyptian history, they don't know about it. I was in the States and the Americans, they have CDs with hieroglyphics. They study that on the sixth grade. We are deprived to know that. We don't know our original history and we are imitating anybody else as we are dropping our character. What is this? We have to revive our culture. We have to speak our language. We have to speak our thinking, not important, you know, these ideas which is coming from anywhere in all over the world. We have to believe that we are the mother of this universe. Actually, it's not something we talk it like
not a fake one.
No. It is the truth, and it has to be taught to these people that this is you are born in this country and you are enjoying a marvelous situation in this world. So you have to enjoy it and do it. And do the perfect job you are entitled to do. What they are entitled to do? To be healthy, to be educated, to be cultured, to be sportive. Because sports and energy brings a brain which is, I think, in a very forgiving and blessing
and a balanced
and psychologically balanced, and even not that much, but genius.
your oxygen balance will be increased in the, your brain cells, so you are thinking brightly.
Mm.
And so this is the issue. We are fighting, and I think we're gonna do it, because a lot of people like Dr. Papers. Yes, Papers, and me, and a lot of women in this society, eager to do something, eager to do the rest.
And they're always working on the ground in rural areas. Yes, they have history, even before the revolution.
Yes, yes.
Let me take you to
28 years, much more.
28 years. That's a long way, you claim, Dr. Iman Peppers. But the debate on women's rights until this very day, when we are celebrating International Women's Day, like every year, seem to be somehow disturbing some people. I mean, sectors in society. Apart from the fundamentalists or from the people with certain extremist ideas and ideologies, usually women and their demands do not really attract much attention except before the elections in order to gain the votes or gain some political interests. Or usually that happens not only in the spheres of the brotherhood elements or the Salafists or the even among other spheres.
But of course, I mean, this is expected if you have a gendered society that is controlled by male thinking, you know. The idea here is that what happens is we don't have a supportive group where women's voices can be heard as much as we would want to. So yes, let us talk about why are women only needed, and even there is a proverb in Arabic where they say, in your weddings we're invited, in your funerals we're invited, but in the weddings we're not. Yeah, something like that. And this is true. Whenever there is a big issue, whenever there is a revolution, whenever there is a demonstration, it's okay for women to go down and demonstrate.
Not only going down, but being the driving force.
Of course,
yes,
being the driving force for everything.
Force.
However, whenever things are then settled, they say, well, go home, or stay home, or the mother's role is the best role. No, we have to understand that it is not about only the Salafis or the Muslim Brothers or the religious group. There is the conservative, male-gendered ideology that has been controlling Egypt for some time. And we cannot deny that this has been filtrating into our society, into the media, into the movies, into our day-to-day activities for the last 30 to 40 years. The Wahhabi mentality is not only about religion, it's about a very, very demeaning and very unrespectful opinion of women. So the idea is not just to say, oh, this is only the Muslim Brothers. What happened after the revolution, the January revolution, for example, there were demonstrations by men, not even by fundamentalists yet. And of course, the Salafis already are attacking us every day up till now. Mm. But even by the other men who wanted women to go home, who are claiming that women are taking their jobs, who wanted to repeal the law of the divorce and marriage, al-khulla, although this is religious. So we have to understand that
this
we
is
are
the bottom of our religion.
and it is very important for us to understand this is a cultural issue that we have to address. That is not our national, that's not our heritage, that is not our identity as Egyptians, but there is a conservative Wahhabi mentality that has really seeped in everywhere, in our schools, in our curriculums, in the media. I mean, up till now, it upsets me so much that, for example, Sheikh Mitwalli or Amma Mitwalli, the guy when Nuri Sharif was married to four women, you know, this movie, and the fact that people came up and said, oh, it's because women are going to be spinsters, and all these arguments which are not scientific. Actually, women are 49.7% of the population, by the way. We are not more than men, so yes, to start with, yes, at all. And this is statistics by the government, not from my imagination.
Yeah.
So the whole idea of getting the media to come in, changing our identity, making us, and of course, and all these fatawi, you know, all these sayings of these...
That's the most dangerous.
Not a religion.
Of course, they are not religion, but at the end of the day...
Not in an Islamic way. No.
But this, on the contrary, Islam...
I'm thinking of Sultanis, of Osman, and the Wahhabi. This is the thing.
The idea, Islam, at the very early years, during the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was much more progressive than we are now, 1,400 years later. So the whole idea of getting all these fatawi by strange people, anybody can go on TV now, have his own channel, and say strange things. In the small mosques in every place, in the rural areas that Dr. Hoda was talking about, the places where I work, there are these, what they call them...
What do you observe in these places?
What I observe in these places is anybody who is claiming, for example, that he's an Azhar graduate, will come in and can sit and make a small area and then start preaching.
Yeah.
You know, Azawiya, and preach. Not sometimes even. And